Hello everyone, I'm Chad Smith, and today we're going to talk about connecting the iFIX OPC UA client to the IGS OPC UA server. So to begin with, we're going to go ahead and open up the OPC UA configuration from the IGS startup icon. We're going to log in. In this configuration, you can see that the OPC UA server endpoint is this endpoint here. So we're going to copy that, and we're going to go ahead and open up the iFIX OPC UA client, which is a driver, and it opens up a web-based configuration, which takes us to a login page, where we log in. And we can see that right now we haven't added any servers, so we're going to go ahead and add the IGS as an OPC UA server that we want to talk to. So we'll put in that URL, we'll discover which policies it supports, and for this demo we're going to show you setting up with the most secure endpoint that the IGS currently supports. So if we go ahead and test that connection, we see that right out of the gate we don't trust this client. So the IGS server doesn't trust this client. So we need to go back into the IGS configuration, go to the trusted clients list, and we'll see that iFIX is in there as untrusted. So let's trust that. Go back and hit test connection again. So we're going to see that now the server isn't trusted. So the server trusts us, we need to trust the server. So now if we go back into iFIX, open up the OPC UA configuration and look at the trust list, we'll see that the IGS is in our untrusted list. We hit the trust button. We now trust the IGS OPC UA server. So technically now if we go back in here, we should be trusted. So now here the problem is that our authentication has failed because we haven't actually set up the authentication username and password. So let's put in our credentials for the OPC UA server in IGS, and when we do that, we are trusted and we're authenticated and our connection is successful. And now that we've got a successful connection, let's go ahead and create that server. So it creates it here in the driver configuration as IGS. We can therefore go ahead and browse that server and start creating tags in iFIX. You can see that it goes out to the server, finds its namespace, allows us to browse into its namespace, and potentially click and decide to create a few tags in iFIX. So we can stage those tags, we can decide to filter those tags, and maybe for this purpose we're only going to create tags associated with ramp 3. So you can see all the tags on ramp 3. We're going to strip off the front level hierarchy level and put a prefix on there. We'll call this area 1 underscore. So you can see it tacks it onto the front. So these are the tag names that would be created in iFIX. We pick up their block types. I could potentially change those if I wanted to do something different. But we'll take the defaults. In this case, I could switch groups. But for now, we're going to take the defaults and we hit create tags. We go out, this goes out to iFIX and starts creating those tags in the iFIX tag database. And there we go, those tags were created successfully. If we go take a look at those tags in the database, we will see that they're created and they're talking. We've connected to the IGS OPC UA server from the iFIX OPC UA client and created valid tags in iFIX to communicate with it.